Today we're talking about this, the Aputure STORM 400X. And the reason we're talking about it is twofold. One, the technology and clever features of this light have left me genuinely impressed and piqued my curiosity enough that I agreed to cover it and wanted to share the cool stuff with you. And two, Aputure sponsored this video and is paying me for this coverage, and Gerald likes money. So this is not an objective review of the 400X, and instead, we're going to take a nerdier dive into those cool new features. So this light is using the BLAIR engine. Now, BLAIR is an acronym that stands for blue, lime, amber, indigo, and red, and those refer to the different emitters on the light. This is similar to the RGB ACL lights, but by dropping the cyan and green emitters and adding in an indigo one, two things became possible. First, the power and quality of the white light created by the 400X goes up over most comparable bicolor lights, full color chips, and even RGB ACL versions. By reducing the number of emitters to just the core required ones, more power is concentrated in fewer emitters and output goes up while keeping size down. Second, the addition of the indigo emitter helps replicate the near UV light that's present in natural daylight that most other fixtures can't produce. This portion of the spectrum causes certain materials to fluoresce, which can create inconsistencies in your final image if your artificial lights aren't capable of also producing that effect. Well, now with the 400X, you can, making it nearly indistinguishable from natural daylight. And this can be seen on the spectrometer when we measure daylight SSI, which is a metric that tells us how close our light is to a known source. In this case, daylight. Usually LED lights score in the low 70s for daylight SSI, but the 400X scores an astonishing 85 in daylight and 87 in tungsten, and these are the best results I've ever recorded. Now, it's an X light from Aputure, which means it's intended as a bicolor light and not a full color light. But because of the various colored emitters, it actually can produce an array of hues. It just can't produce the greens and cyans as saturated as a full color light can. I would say imagine a conventional full color light, set it to cyan, and then turn down the saturation a little bit, and you get the 400X. But the reds, blues, purples, and so on look fantastic, and I think it would fool most people into believing it was a true full-color light. So I'm happy Aputure included this option, even if that isn't the intended purpose. To be specific though, this light is capable of about 70% of the Rec 2020 color space. But that also means you have full green magenta control when using it as a daylight or tungsten source. And best of all, they've improved the way the green and magenta shift is implemented. Something I complained about on most other lights in the past is that you never really knew what you were getting when you added green or magenta. It didn't correlate to anything and was unpredictable. And without a spectrometer, you wouldn't even know how much green you were adding by just increasing it a point or two on the light. Well, with the 400X, it's finally a logical and useful system. If you add 100% green, that's a full stop. 50% is half a stop green. 25% magenta is a quarter stop magenta, and so on. So if you're on set and someone calls for an eighth green, you can just put 12.5% G on your light and you're where you need to be. This is fantastic. And for even more granular control, they've included an option to set the standard of white light that you're targeting. You can choose between black body and CIE daylight. And this is a very interesting setting, but it requires some explanation. So if you didn't know, a black body is an idealized theoretical object that absorbs all electromagnetic radiation that falls on it, and because of that appears perfectly black at room temperature. But it's also a perfect emitter of thermal radiation and has a specific continuous spectrum that depends only on temperature, which means that as it heats up, it glows and shifts the light it emits to shorter wavelengths, going from red to yellow and eventually to blue-white. The closest real-world approximation we have to this that's used in lighting is tungsten. When electricity flows through a tungsten filament, it behaves a bit like a black body. And when you warm that tungsten filament up to 3200 degrees Kelvin, you get the color of light emitted that we think of when we say 3200K color temperature. I've always found that fact to be interesting, the origin of using the Kelvin scale for color temperature in lights. Anyway, this curve that tracks that black body as it heats up is known as the Planckian locus, and you can follow it all the way up to 5600 Kelvin and beyond to approximate daylight temperature. And in fact, that's what most competing LED lights do. And that's also where the 400X differs and where that CIE daylight option comes in. So natural daylight is significantly affected by the Earth's atmosphere, which scatters, absorbs, and reflects certain wavelengths of light. This creates a deviation from the black body approximation and what natural daylight actually does. So the CIE created a new standard to account for those differences and are based on real-world measurements, not the black body curve. So this means that if you set this light to CIE daylight, you'll have a more accurate and better mixing daylight source than any competing light that uses conventional black body methods. But because Aputure made it a selection, you can still set it to black body if you need to match other lights that don't have the CIE option. It's a very powerful and thoughtful inclusion. Another considerate addition is the ability to set the maximum current for V-mount batteries. In the past, I've had issues using my compact V-mount batteries for cameras on lights because the lights demanded higher amperage than my batteries provided. With the 400X, you can choose between 10, 12, 15, and 20 amp options, so even my tiny 150 watt BBAW batteries can work now, which is sweet. The light just intelligently limits itself in max output to match the chosen battery spec, and the tooltip on the screen conveys this nicely. Well done. Now, beyond those clever additions, the rest is pretty standard and what we've come to expect from a high-quality COB light from Aputure. I'll still quickly go over the basic features, but first I want to draw your attention to the Bowens mount because it's special on the 400X. It's a positive lock system, meaning you don't turn the modifier to lock in place. You just hold the modifier and turn a locking ring instead, just like you'd find on a large cinema camera. It seems so obvious now that this is a much better system. I don't know why we had to struggle for so long with trying to rotate a giant modifier while lifting it like a bozo and seemingly always getting the insertion angle wrong. This is so much easier and more elegant. And it also prevents the wobbles and movement you get from a traditional Bowens mount, which means precision modifiers like Fresnels and spotlights are more optimally aligned with the light engine. Oh yeah, they have a new optional compact 7-inch Fresnel and barn doors kit that's optimized for this light. It's called the CF7. And when you combine all of these aspects together, like the improved white light, the better engine, the better Bowens mount, and the optimized Fresnel, this 400X can output nearly 5,000 more lux with its Fresnel than the 600X Pro can with its F10 attached. That's crazy if you consider how much smaller and more agile this thing is, especially this new ballast, which is very well designed and significantly more compact than I was expecting, especially when compared to the previous, 300 series that was less powerful but larger than this. It's light, it's compact, still uses that great little clamp you can put on your C-stands. It just feels really robust, really well built, dials, knobs, everything. It's terrific. Now, like I said, the rest of the stuff is pretty standard, but still fully featured. You've got a full suite of controls from the Sidus Link app, the DMX and CRMX. You've got studio mode for power, so you can decide whether the light turns on when it receives power or if you have to press the power button. You have control over your fan speed, including a silent mode, which I always appreciate. The silent mode limits the output to 10% of the original and will net you around 2,700 lux at 1 meter without modifiers, which for reference is roughly equivalent to your average 60 watt COB at 100% power, which isn't bad for something completely silent. There's also a full complement of lighting effects, dimming curves, lead follow mode, XY matching. It's got everything. If you want to see a full list of photometrics, I'll flash them on the screen now if you want to pause, or you can just go to Aputure's website. I did validate many of their poster results with my C800 and found them to be quite accurate and very impressive compared to most of the competing lights on the market. Oh yeah, and it's IP65 rated, meaning it's completely dust tight and can resist low pressure water ingress from any direction. I assume that mostly applies to rain, but you never know. And I think that's all I have to say about this light. It truly is a fantastic fixture and a slam dunk from Aputure. And I hope you enjoyed chatting about black bodies and near UV fluorescence. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Yeah, all right. I'm done. Better move out the way, cause I'm coming with harder hits. My head is as hard as a brick, but I'm harder than all it is.